$7.34. That was the price. Just sitting in a junkyard waiting for some kids to find him and find that magical horn that would transform little old Slepkar into Wonderbug. I've gotten lots of comments requesting a Wonderbug video. Yes, I watched it as a kid, and yes, I loved it. And it passed the merch test with flying colors. This is just a smidgen of the numerous items available to a discriminating shopper back in the late 70s. Didn't have the game or the lunchbox, but I did have the Viewmaster, and my little bro had the coloring book, I think. There was also a Gold Key comic book. I seem to recall reading an issue or two. Beyond the merchandise, this show was popular for a reason. It was just fun. They were like 12 or 13 minute episodes, short and sweet, nothing original about it. In fact, the show took its cues from a Hanna-Barbera cartoon called Speed Buggy, as well as Disney's Love Bug movie series. And the cast had a ton of chemistry. Watching the episodes now, many of them can still be found on YouTube. Anyway, watching the episodes now, it's clear that these three actors had no grand aspirations regarding what they were doing on the show.
And let's not forget about good old Slepkar.
Truly the heart of the show, not that grandstanding show-off Wonderbug. Well, actually, both cars were voiced by veteran actor Frank Welker. His list of accomplishments, well, it's just too darn long to cover here on this short video, but let's just say Frank, who was the original voice of Fred on Scooby-Doo, continues to do great work to this day. So that's it. Did you enjoy Wonderbug? Was it your favorite part of the Croft Super Show? Let me know what you think in the comments section below, and while you're at it, I'd love you to click on the thumbs up icon, and I would be honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.